Ladies and gentlemen, here we are at OCWS with the Team Daniel Memorial Show. And we're getting ready to kick off this show with a singles match between Paul Phoenix and Warren
Fleece.
First entry, it's Psychology 101. Dysfunctional. Yeah, don't you bring me nothing stupid. If you don't want me to lose it, step back. If you don't want me to attack, I'm a beast, better give me the deuces. I have no tolerance for nonsense, get away from me. Me, I wanna get dollars, don't wanna holler, but you making me. I'm a little dysfunctional, you're the problem, please don't awaken me. And I'm that way, cause back in the day, most have forsaken me. Lottie Dottie, I'm at the party. On a drunk night with a punk mind, doing trying to pick a fight because he's sorry.
You know what my first name is. Every single person here knows my first name is.
Or is it Craig?
POS.
It's Craig. It's
peace. Every single person here knows I am the best wrestler in OCW.
Really?
Every single person here knows I am the greatest champion ever seen at this place. Unfortunately, it gets scrapped every time it happens.
That's just because
now,
I never won the
battle. As usual, I am climbing the ladder of success. What? Starting from the bottom, I will not just end at the top.
Don't you mean step stool?
I am not here to prove that I'm the best, because every single one of you already knows it.
That's
what?
It's not
mine.
Use the hammer as a microphone. Stop!
Yeah. First All name right. Billy, last name Billy.
Damn it.
Can you pull up the whole fucking poster on your phone, Tess? Oh, wait, what's gonna be?
Dub! If he says boom, I'm gonna spit on him. No, no response, no. Hi, no. Fuck you too, man.
What?
Asshole.
Good match, just got for one fall.
One fall!
Big old bastard.
Pretty
hair.
Nice, it's official.
What?
So what's up, Pete? Like, why do you look like a battered woman? You didn't say nothing. I'm like, fucking asshole. You didn't respond.
You guys talking?
Well, I said battered woman. I didn't say you are a woman.
In a corner to my left, Dick. Billy.
I know that you care.
What do you want from me?
Corner to my right.
Billy.
Miss Congeniality.
Corner to my right. Billy.
Behind the camera. Billy.
Bring the Billy. Ring the Billy.
Billy.
No, not yet.
Check me if I may not, Billy.
You and my shit and whatnot. Ladies and gentlemen, if you close your eyes, it sounds like a gay porno, by the way.
I think only you would know.
Actually, Drix is the one. Dix.
You're matching really well, Tots. You're matching really well, Tots.
Nice quick line by Avada.
You match him really well, Todd.
Paul Phoenix, Avocado,
Orange.
Nirvana, Nirvana.
Avocado.
Avocado.
Avocado, Nevada.
Avada Kedavra?
Yeah. Gator roll. And another one. Come on, one more. There we go. Wait for two more.
Oh, they're probably trying to
get this.
So, we are at a set of sequences and chains right now at this current moment between... Oh, what a club to the back. Looks like he caught an elbow to the spine. Might have flapjacked his nutsack.
Sorry, part of the job squad,
ladies and gentlemen, also, just for reference, it's me and the D-bag, Billy D. Oh! D-bag, infamous kids.
Yeah! Right, Tommy? Yeah!
Yeah, wait, why are we even standing next to each other? Don't we have a match in a minute?
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh. Well, fuck you anyway.
Drive by.
The crowd going wild here at OCWS.
Woo!
Oh,
that's fine, man. You just bring it in.
Let's get back in here.
Which one?
I hope the water breaks.
Oh, gosh, that's pretty strong. Weak any stone, man.
What's he doing?
Three! Nope. Go on.
Five.
Look. It looked long as hell. Like, is that the same case as you?
I was like...
Oh, that was fucking dick.
You're an asshole.
You
wonder why nobody likes you.
That was pretty cool. Looking, you see that? The shoulder block to the head from the tree of woe. I actually like that.
Kick at it too.
Might have to use that. What? This is Jimbo Jism here.
Jimbo Jism.
No. Yes, he knew what the reference was from.
Whoa!
Yeah, I missed it too. I was Snapchatting.
That was kind of fucked up, in all honesty. Yeah, but like. In reality, that was that good. It didn't sound like somebody was taking a leak.
Yes.
Warren setting up.
Yes.
Putting him in the pendulum.
Get him, Warren.
One. Two.
Come on. Put me down.
Three.
Three.
Warren Peace.
Warren Fleece. Three.
That was four.
Next spot. I said three, didn't I?
Yeah.
Oh!
Next spot is your face
you
hits the back.
Are an asshole.
Do it again!
Asshole. Asshole.
Oh, come on. Come on.
Every time before an asshole, I don't know. Okay, good. His foot's on the rope, dick.
So he's supposed to be face.
Yeah, right?
That's pretty heel of him.
Yep.
Did you fucking wink at me?
Get up!
You heard the kid, get up!
Look out, ref. Jesus.
Ooh, that was close.
Stop! Hey, let's go, get back in the ring. Hey!
Dirty mouth.
You got a very purty face, though.
Yo, I find that offensive.
That's why
did you fall
I'm the top
heavens?
Dog in the
yard.
Get back in here now, Warren.
Hey, dog, did you fall to the heavens? Because your face looks pretty fucked up.
Oh. It looks like you wanted him to win, didn't you?
Two.
I bet you wanted him to win.
Three.
Too bad you don't get what you want in this life.
Four.
You gotta give him a child, bro.
Gotta give him a child, bro.
As long as that was quite
So, pretty shitty about that. So.
Three.
It's his idea.
Four. Five. Six.
Paul should get the win for that.
Seven.
I think that always makes me laugh when I see that. Like,
it's just... Break the cap. One.
Oh. Don't
two.
Oh my God, Kyle.
Ah. Three.
Do it.
Four.
Yo, Warren, you got 4-year-olds telling you you suck.
Six.
You suck. Yeah. You suck. You suck.
Seven.
Yeah, give me a minute. Gotta load it on the iPod.
Hey, looks like Paul Phoenix is the winner. Nope, wrong music, jackass.
The iPod froze.
Oh, it froze.
It's alright, my song is a new ring bell.
Well, he is the champion, so I guess.
Everybody shut up.
Boom, I am boom, the ending. Boom, and boom, the beginning boom. Of the match. Meeting our winner.
Bye, bye, bye.
Keep rolling.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep rolling.
I won!
Yeah!
I won! Paul won a match! 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 Paul won a match!
Holy Paul! Holy Paul! Avada Kedavra.
A lot of people say that you're the worst one here.
And they are right.
Not a single one of them tries to improve themselves as much as you do, though.
Except for me.
You are the
best. Yeah, JD. And Benjamin.
Now, where the hell are these hoes?
I am so sorry, Maddox. I apologize. I will buy you a piece of candy.
He's lying.
You
lying.
You rapist.
Paul won a match! Paul won a match! Paul won a match!
Barely!
Yeah! Yeah!
And we'll be back. Go.
Fucking elbow drop!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back with OCWS's memorial show for Team Daniel. Or by Team Daniel, actually. I'm sorry about that. And this is a match between Tommy Guns and Jeff Ragenrock. This is also a singles match.
Fatal 4-way.
Fatal 4-way. Oh, well then, who's
for the contract.
Oh, this is a fatal 4-way for the contract. I am sorry, I was misinformed. We have Jeff Ragenrock here, putting up his contract. Oh, against James Spino. And I couldn't tell you who else it's gonna be.
We've been seeing what you want, and God is gonna run
now. Oh, I know. There's a mystery opponent to this, ladies and gentlemen. So we're just waiting to see who his opponent's gonna be. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have a great match still for you. Hello, YouTube. Go fuck yourself. Coming out next. This is Tommy Guns, ladies and gentlemen. Find them. They're right there.
I doubt that.
Alright, now next we have yeah!
and gentlemen, it's the Stiff Man himself, the one of these Fly Away Batman. Fly away, Batman.
That's more like an alligator.
Who's this?
Chopper.
Speed.
Yeah,
don't even get a
lot. No, that sense. Oh, that's the chase. Chopper.
Didn't we already do instructions?
Yeah, the red and black and the bulge.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I will be the announcer.
Come on! Never mind.
Come on. I will be the announcer because I have the voice. In the corner to my right, we have wearing the red and black tights with the black magic tape pads and the bulge to boot, Tommy Guns!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Totally almost
in the corner to my left, we have rocking the safari khakis. Sometimes rapping foot up somewhere. James the Safari Speedo! And in the corner to my far right, we have rocking the blue and black attack. He is Ryan Ragnarok!
Yeah, you called him an asshole, Jeff! Yeah.
My bad, I fucked up his name. What'd you call him? Jeff.
Retirement Jeff.
Yeah, I meant to say Ryan.
Achilles! Wearing the Batman gloves and shirt to match. Troy, he has
Troy Ryan!
Blown up!
It's the half tard!
Come on! You guys suck! I'll knock you down! Don't be so pumped now.
Yes, it is.
I want to see a double headbutt, huh?
Yeah! You're gonna have to.
Face of Mariah.
Don't act like you're not impressed.
I am impressed. Just
Nah, it's a
big ball. And a miss by Ray Rock. Nice counter by Pariah.
I'm selling.
Big boot. Leaving the man posted up in the corner. I think he's knocked out, ladies and gentlemen. Oops, get him up. And a snap suplex.
I'm going to rub this pile.
One, two.
Going to be like, this was on my dick. It's like, this was on my dick.
Another big boot.
The half tards in the ring together.
Half tards.
You
guys are
going to
get these little kids screaming
half-tard.
Great.
Sorry, you already made one cry.
Yes!
I try to be a face and I'm a
Yo, Killers, how you stand?
You know there's like a broken cross into the map. I'm selling. Ow.
Smack him in the ankle!
Nope, I remember that.
You ever get put into a fatal four-way ladder match that had no finish? That shit's fun.
Wait, what?
Look at this, look at him, guys! Main event ladder match.
Nice!
Lester. And I realized midway we had no finish.
That's okay, I was playing 2K14.
I do it better!
I was playing 2K14.
Oh!
Like, damn, look at the height from Ryan Ragnarok.
Oh, what was it? WrestleMania mode?
Going up top.
No, it was just WWE Universe. And they put him in the match with like three creative characters. And there's no way to finish. Like, there's no pinning, no submission. Like, that was both off. There's KOs were off. There's no way to win this match at all.
Does it have the Spino?
Counter by Pariah.
Stardust.
Speedo! Kicking people in the head.
No. Hey, the ankle! Think about this, Speedo!
What do you say? What do you get for being brothers with a different last name?
They're so fucking shit
up. No, 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 no.
What do you say?
No.
You fucked up. What do you say? You
sound pretty fucking faithful to me.
Clap, Brian!
And Speedo wins.
Oh, Ryan, are you okay?
Ding, ding.
Ryan and Ragnar lost.
See you in another 6 months.
Start up, stop.
7, 28.
Bring it up that box.
Oh, this is a 6-man tag match?
It's a regular tag match.
Regular tag match? Our tag match.
I'd like to begin with a first danger.
Who let the guy who can't talk do commentary?
I did.
I love you.
What?
Ding, ding, ding. I already have the end music set. I'm not ringing the bell.
Kick their stomach. Everybody from this kid.
Oh,
what a backbreaker.
Yeah,
hey, buddy.
Always a pleasure.
Always.
Oh, nice.
Jock. Oh. Going on. And there's
the
Honey out over here. Honey out over here.
Great shot.
I need help. I don't know what I'm doing.
You're trying to talk.
Fine.
Fuck out of here.
One. Count fast.
Oh, I want to kick their stomach again. Yeah. Really? Infamous belly is sending off the rope.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Russell Mulligan here. I apologize for showing up late. My pay will be docked. Luckily, Booker D told me that I still have my job. Seems I have come in at the middle of the tag team bout. Both teams trying to work their way up the ladder towards that tag team title championship match that will be decided later between the Saints of Truth and DK Adventures.
DK Adventures, that's the guy, no one.
Technically not together, but put together by luck of the draw for the aforementioned last week's tag team tournament.
What a tournament has been.
Tournament has been good. Unfortunately, both these teams eliminated from the tournament, trying to work their way back into it. Big whip to the corner.
Safari for my selfie Sunday.
Kyle Black
Jim Madden here.
Going head first.
Looks like we got Jim Madden here in the commentary booth, and it looks like Infamous Kid is rubbing Kyle Black's face on the rope. Get him off, ref.
A very smart move. I'm not going to say I'm the biggest fan of Infamous Kid as a person, but his style in there is flashy yet effective at the same time. It is beautiful to watch this man go to work, even on a man twice his size. Taking it to him. 1 minute just at the ass end of headbutts, but now taking it to Kyle Black.
You're absolutely right. The Infamous Kid is the one who overcomes the odds, and we might see him overcome the odds here tonight.
Off the rope.
I said he's good.
Oh, Kyle Black getting behind the Infamous Kid. Dragging him back towards those ropes.
Ringing his neck on the ropes.
Uh-oh, what's he got going on here?
Has him locked in. Again, with the vicious headbutts.
Oh.
Not sure if it's his head or his
butt. He's got him. He's up.
Set up on the shoulders for a powerbomb onto the ropes.
Oh!
And taking the Hurricane Rana.
And a big Rana to the side. Here comes the Infamous Kid. Oh! A big leg to the back of his head.
And overshooting a little bit. Kyle Black enjoying that moment to breathe.
Oh!
As Infamous Kid not appreciating his laughter. I think he was supposed to hit him on his way down.
It looked like he cut his leg.
And now,
Kyle Black with his big signature slam.
Huge bear hug cover. Slam.
Yes, easy kick.
Only the two count. I really thought that could have been it for Infamous Kid. Wesker, on the other hand, seeming a little more confident that his tag team partner was going to get out of that one.
Of course I am.
Of course he is. Kyle Black, not wearing his glasses in the ring, can't seem to find the mark against Infamous Kid.
He's a fighter, never
did. Oh!
Comes in, doesn't see the big toe kick to the stomach, sets him up, looks like a DDT.
Oh!
Dropping the big man on his head. Smart maneuver to keep the big man down. Infamous Kid needs to take advantage of this moment. It's not often you get a man like Kyle Black to stay down for more than 3 seconds. That could have been a pinfall, but instead, the arrogant Infamous Kid would rather keep dishing out the pain.
Speaking of pain, here comes Joshua Wesker.
Nothing screams pain like Wesker. Big slap to the chest. It is always nice to see Wesker just manhandle men bigger than himself. It's like a great porn with this guy.
Wesker, what a backbreaker.
And a
big backbreaker, setting him up. Slingshot leg drop by Infamous Kid. Great double team maneuver there. Doesn't look like he got all of it, but it might have been just effective enough for Wesker to keep Kyle Black at his mercy.
Well, like a single leg side leg drop type thing.
A leg drop.
A leg drop. Nonetheless.
Huge slap to the chest.
One,
now for all of those watching at home who believe wrestling is fake, I'd like you to rewind and watch that slap to the chest again and see if you can tell me how fake wrestling is. Of course, the only people that watch our shows are other wrestlers, so...
Take that, Drix's lighter.
Where is it?
I lost it.
I'm pretty sure.
Yep.
I'm pretty sure JD had not been in the match yet.
Oh, come on. He's been throwing people's stuff around the yard all day. Someone has to mess with him.
Joshua Wesker putting Kyle Black into the corner.
I'm pretty sure JD Slayer has not been in the match yet.
Clubbing away at the chest of Kyle Black. Whips him into the other corner. Kyle Black takes guard. Oh, and a big kick to the shoulder block
going for
by
the,
Kyle Black.
Looks here like he missed it. Big back suplex. That poor ring. All 600 pounds of these two men slamming on that ring. I think we better check under the ring and see if a bar might have broke. JD Slayer coming in hot and full of energy. Probably the most energetic out of the three men in there.
Yeah, there he goes, cross arm breaker.
And a little
bit the end of the match. Infamous Kid looks worried about his teammate. He might jump in at this. JD Slayer breaks it up.
No, Wesker had the rope break there. Unfortunately, the ref in the way, the fans at home might not have seen it, but Wesker had the rope break.
Oh, Jim Madden, you see, Kelly's elbow is in his face.
The good sport that JD Slayer is, let's go before even a one count.
Uh-oh, here comes.
Because he wants to win this
Baron Slayer. Oh!
Huge second rope leg drop. And he sits on his face. Again, when Wesker's in the ring, it's like a great porn.
Oh, he's got the ropes. He's got to break up the hold.
This time a little bit smarter. You don't want to let go before the five count with Wesker.
Hello.
Wesker needs to get it in. Wesker, if you want to keep Wesker down, you dish out all the pain you can. Smart move by Infamous Kid, kicking in just to make sure he gets off of his partner who did have the rope. A more vicious style from JD Slayer, usually the flashy wrestler.
Oh, left here.
Oh no, Joshua Wesker.
If you have not met Joshua Wesker, it is, you have to note the sharp nails that this man keeps at his disposal. If we could get a close-up of Wesker's nails right now, it is gruesome, and you know when he grabs your face, you could lose an eyeball. And this crowd just going mild. Big whip into the corner by Wesker, again with those vicious slaps. Those open hand, overhead chops. Just, you gotta think, just the arm of Wesker. Oh, and a beautiful head scissors out of the corner. May have given JD Slayer the break he needs to try and beat this. Big drop kick to the back, sandwiching the man into the corner. And a huge Bronco Buster. JD Slayer looking a little winded, but isn't quite done. Crab walking across the rope. What could he be setting up here?
Blame it on the alcohol.
The drink.
One, two.
And only a two count after that splash by JD Slayer. But Wesker going out needs the breather. And unfortunately, that breather cut off by the big man Kyle Black. And what could the infamous kid getting set up and accidentally taking out his own partner? That could have been to no help to the infamous. Do they have a name yet? The infamous and the vicious Wesker and Kid.
One.
Vicious infamous.
Two.
Come out. Invicious.
Three. Four. Five.
How about Naked
that's
and Famous?
Legal. We have Fireball. We're not sharing.
You see how little I got left? Heck.
Infamous Kid, knowing that his buddy needs the breather.
Uh-oh.
Getting caught.
JD Slayer.
Oh, but he gets him. Reverses the Roaring 20s into a great cradle DDT. And you got to think that's got to be all of it. That's got to be it. There's no way. And he gets out. I didn't see that coming. Did you see that coming? I forgot to read the script, so
did
I had no idea that was happening.
One coming at all.
And the ref has been tagged in. Infamous Kid, huge body shots. Each shot knocking the wind out a little bit more. Slap while the ref isn't looking. Not an illegal maneuver, but still not the most sportsmanlike conduct I've seen today.
Now, Jim Madden, just how exciting has today been so far here at the Daniel Hart's Benefit Memorial?
Sorry, say that again.
How exciting has today been so far? We had the singles match where Paul Phoenix actually won for the first time in well over a year.
You're absolutely right. It was a big accomplishment for Mr. Phoenix.
And then, probably my favorite match so far, Spino is now the number one contender, taking the
Let me stop you there real quick, Mr. Peace.
Please, fill me in. I did
miss
the
actually first happened was that Ryan Ragnarok had his contract up for his for the OCWS championship, and he lost.
Ooh, I'm sorry. Big Alabama slam-like maneuver by J.D. Slayer might be hit the one. The two, and the kick out, unfortunately. So, please go on.
So Safari Spino now has the opportunity to cash in whenever he likes.
So this is very much like a Money in the Bank contract that Ragnarok arrogantly decided to put up for grabs.
You're absolutely right.
That is incredible.
Ragnarok thought he was better than the 20 men in the ring, and he was wrong.
A gutsy move by the man, and maybe any other day he would have been right, but today was not that day, as Spino now has the chance to cash in whenever he would like.
And the thing about that match is that Ryan Ragnarok was not actually the one who got pinned.
Not at all.
And there wasn't even one to begin with. Safari Spino actually made Pariah.
The returning Pariah
tap out.
Much like it. And the big man, Kyle Black, dragging his partner across the ring from the outside. That power coming into a big advantage right there.
You're absolutely right. Kyle Black is now fired up against the Infamous Kid.
I don't know if that tag was a legal move or not, but the ref doesn't seem to argue with him, and I don't blame him.
You're absolutely right.
You know, Kyle Black is a scary man. He really is. You gotta know that he could break anyone in half. Big poke to the eye to the already blind Kyle Black.
Where is he?
He went to the store for like 20 minutes before his
match. Where did he go though? Did he go with Vinny?
No, Vinny said he was
gonna
watch
one. Damn, that's
big front drop kick. Both men very winded. All four of these competitors have given everything they've had in this match.
He suck. See?
But again, as I was saying, Kyle Black is a scary man. I think the only thing scarier than when he doesn't fall from a hit is when he smiles. Nothing scarier than a happy Kyle Black. Because the only time he's happy is when he's hurting someone. And again, those headbutts, that cranium has to be about 21 inches around. And it, when he hits you with it, it hurts.
Yeah, why do we always get the wrong?
Absolutely right.
I know I'm right, Jim Madden. Russell Mulligan is never wrong.
That's fucked.
I'm blaming the fireball, man.
Blame it on the fireball. Oh, and a huge half crab bending him in half like a scorpion.
Yo, don't forget to mention the bridge. Kyle Black, bridge.
That wasn't much of a bridge. Alright, that's kind of a bridge. And a bow and arrow lock grabbing the head and leg, almost making them meet.
Yo, he just raked his eyes.
And J.D. Slayer claiming that Infamous Kid raped his eyes. Awkward.
Oh man, I felt it on my leg. It could reach his eyes. Two.
Both men down, the ref beginning the double down count. One of them does not make it to both feet in 10 seconds. It'll be a draw. Both men up at the same time, getting a running start at each other. Duck in the line goes Kyle Black, kicks him in the stomach to cut him off. And a huge spike DDT, shades of Gangrella on that one. Looks like Kyle Black might have this all won.
Yeah. We ain't done yet, buddy.
Oh my god.
I'm sorry.
Bye. You better tell his mom you're sorry. God, jeez Louise.
They killed him!
Todd.
Who's Luis? No, that was a cool ass DDT.
He landed on his leg though, so.
Big Paluka's beating you, Todd.
Yeah, I know, because his defense has got 22.
And blocks the diving headbutt with an RKO. And it looks like Infamous Kid and Wesker have won over the fun-loving Dirtbags and Do-Rags. Right, what's the Why, yes, the count was not. Smart move by Infamous Kid. JD Slayer came to break up the count, and he decided to kick him in the stomach instead. Yo, Doc.
And we're back with OCWS's benefit show. Out first, we have.
Biggest stage, they came to see us switch a game. Shouldn't be difficult to explain just why you came back again. You hate the fame, love the game, cold as ice. You remain, fuck them all, tell them all. Back the fuck up, watch what you do. Punk? Bitch? Motherfucker? What?
And up next we have.
The same ones that I dealt with, put it all out on the line with. If you're looking for me, you can find wit in the new car or the crown
with. Ladies and gentlemen, Russell Mulligan here commentating. Not quite our main event, but the finals of our tag team tournament set up last week between two members of the Saints of Truth going against another member of the Saints of Truth teamed up with Killa K. Killa K and Drix with absolute problems between the two of them. And still somehow managed to get put together by draw of the hat for this tag team tournament. Few of the teams that were put together, such as Kyle Black and JD Slayer, get along great. Unfortunately, Drix and Killa, part of DK Adventures, split up when Drix joined the Saints of Truth. You know Drix will be trying to make sure the Saints of Truth leave with the tag team titles, and as usual, trying to bury and eliminate his partner slash enemy, Killa K. You gotta see what Killa K's gotta do here. He came out with that shovel as an equalizer. This is a 3-on-1 situation. It is only a great arm drag to start off out of the wheelbarrow position against St. Vengeance. Killa K's partner not even in the corner. This is for the tag team championships. This is the finals of our tournament last week. Killa K wants those titles and he doesn't care who his partner is. Since day one, Killa K has been out here to prove he's the best, and by God, he might do it today. Quick quick snapmare after the trip up by that dude, Troop. Dropkick to the back of the neck. Same Vengeance now in control of Killer K. Killer K's partner, not even on the corner, has no interest in helping out his partner. Kick shoulder up at the two count, but the sleeper hold put on by that dude, Troop. And Drix now attacking his own partner, Killer K. Killer K, no longer the legal man, needs to get out of the match before the five count. I don't believe that would count as a legal tag, but the ref is absolutely powerless at the moment. In this three-on-one attack, I'm not sure how Killer K can manage this one. He is an underdog story. He always manages to come back, but I just don't see it happening this time.
Stop humping Killer!
I don't know about humping, but they have definitely fucked Killer in this situation. Killer K not giving up. The never say I quit attitude that is Killer K. He never stays down. He never wants to be the one on the bottom of the pin. Cut off by the clothesline from Same Vengeance. And Same Vengeance letting Killer tag in his partner Drix, but I really don't know if partner is the word for this. As now, I mean, the legal man is out of the ring. He should be getting counted out right now, but I don't know if they can win a title by countout.
You can't.
Exactly. Neither competitor is the champion, so therefore it would just be a draw, so they can't finish it by countout.
S.O.T. S.O.T.
And Drix tagging Killer back in after attacking him. By God, I swear this has to be the most awkward match I have ever seen. It is a three-on-one situation where Killer K's partner is against him. Killer K's partner does not want him to win. Big Orange Crush powerbomb coming out of that dude, Truth, and I gotta admit that's something I've never seen him do before. Now with the half crab, grabbing the arm just to take leverage away. Grabbing the other arm, trapping them both. This might be one of the more awkward maneuvers I've ever seen. Killer K just twisted in all sorts of directions. I can't tell if he's facing north, south, east, or west.
Go in the ring.
S.O.T.
fan, come on! Huge side effect like Uranagi Slam by that dude Truth, but Killer K again kicking out, just not letting it happen. Killer K came here to win, even if it means dying before losing. And unfortunately, I think that might be what it takes for them to actually beat him. They may have to legitimately kill Killer. The huge butterfly neck breaker. And Killer K is not the legal man. He needs to get out of the ring. How the ref can allow any of this to happen? And Drix is laying down, allowing that dude Truth to pin him. But Killer K breaks it up. Huge shuffle sidekick, taking out the sternum of him. Grabs him for the neck breaker. And twists him into a spinning DDT. He could have broken the man's neck on that one. Vicious move, taking out his own partner. And a code breaker from the outside. Clothesline to the back of the head into a side headlock. And Drix claiming it is a tag and that Killer K has to get in. What? That dude Truth accidentally running into the post. And Killer K taking out his own partner, wringing his leg on the rope, and
you
just stopping
Drix taking out Killer K.
I'm lost in this match. I apologize, guy who's not actually commentating.
I'm only here for corrections.
I appreciate it. Everybody needs a proofreader, and they didn't give me the script. because I don't think they even know exactly what's going on in this match. They just know they have the upper hand against Killer K, and they are well on their way to becoming the champ. Until he hits that big swinging neck-breaking DDT.
You talking about this on script? This is wrestling. It's real.
It's looking pretty real right now. As Killer K's trying to mount a comeback, but he keeps getting cut off at every corner, be it by his opponents or his partner. And a spinning side slam, hopefully taking out, and I gotta say, I'm hoping, but his own partner breaks it up, trying to make sure the titles go home with the Saints of Truth. A German suplex may have taken out Killer K.
If you can call that a German. It was like a side.
I guess that was more like an Irish suplex. And a big Jewish suplex takes out Killer K.
I'll go with that one.
Again, being double teamed, you'd think they would have no problem hurting this man by themselves, but they just gotta take every cheap maneuver, always looking for the fastest way to win these guys. Using the five count to their advantage to choke Killer K in the corner. Looking for that signature cartwheel Death Valley driver.
Pete! Thank you.
And Killer K still managing to kick out.
Every time you boo drinks, you get a kick.
And it looks like that dude Truth just having a little too much fun beating up poor Killer K at this moment. I feel for this man. Killer K again thrown off the rope. Set up for the huge backbreaker, signature move by Saint Vengeance. Vengeance now putting him into that reverse figure four. Haven't seen anyone tap out to it yet, but I would not blame Killer K for letting go right now.
SOT! SOT!
And Killer K needs to find a way out of this predicament if he wants to take those tag titles home reluctantly with his unfortunate partner, Dr. Nine Drix.
Dr. Nine?
Nine? D-R-I-X, Dr. Nine.
Dr. Nine?
Roman numeral. Ducking the clothesline, Killer K trying to mount a comeback. Canadian Destroyer! Just the ticket that he may have needed. He's been looking for it this whole time, and he may have found it. He needs to cover him up right now. And Drix coming in, helping his Saints of Truth family. And, you know, they may have needed him right there. Really looked like Killer K might have had him beat with that Canadian Destroyer. That sick flip pile driver, but getting cut off yet again.
I just thought...
Shut the fuck up and watch the fucking match.
By God, he's been holding that man up in the air for at least 3 years now.
Beautiful.
Now taking a victory lap while holding the man up. And Drix using this time to just mess with the fans.
Let's go, ref. Come on. 1, 2, 3. Easy.
In the side headlock with the cocky headstand, though mostly just flash, he is putting a lot of pressure on the back of Killer K's neck, who has been slammed on that thing more than 100 times over his career, and you know it's a great way to possibly make the man tap out, switching to the other side, keeping things fresh, and now again just rubbing it in the face of Killer K.
Yeah, I bet.
Is that from the DDT that I gave you?
Yeah.
That thing looked vicious, man.
It was.
And and a huge backstabber while Saint Vengeance was hung up on the rope after going for that face wash kick. Again, another move that he desperately needed to possibly win this match. Possibly crawling over to his partner, but he knows for a fact that his partner wants nothing to do with this. And Killer K wants to win, so he's not bringing him in. Going in for that signature corner clothesline. Going for the complete shot. Complete shot. Face plant into the ground. Baseball slide drop kick into the super kick to the side of the face. But unfortunately, that dude, Truth, cutting it off from the other side. It looks as if there's no way for Killer K to win this. He is being attacked by all sides. Huge drive-by, that jumping vertical swinging neck breaker. And again, that might be it, but I don't see it when he's being attacked from all sides. Shoulder up as Drix was coming in to break up the count, you gotta presume. I highly doubt he was in there to help his partner. I've just never seen such a smart and diabolical team as that dude Truth, Saint Vengeance, and Drix. They all have the talent to win, but they would much rather use the quick shortcuts at the best they can. Going for that suplex into the double Uranagi, instead taken out by a DDT and breaking the boot across the back of the head is Saint. That dude, Truth. Killer K getting picked up into that fireman's carry position. Swing around into the sidewalk slam. I've seen him put away a few people with that move. But again, the never say die attitude of the goonie Killer K. I like it. This match is gonna suck. Setting him up for what looks like his whiplash neck breaker yet again. And he takes it. Second time we've seen that maneuver. Might put him out. Goes for the leg drop. That tail grab leg drop. Now setting him up for that big knee to the face. Smart Killer K just staying on top of him while he has the energy. But he has just expended so much energy. And Drix now taking out the ref to ensure Killer K does not win those tag team titles. And the ref making Drix look like a bitch as he stands back up. Not that Drix did anything. Again, Killer K back on the ground. This 3-on-1 assault is just taking it to him. He could be down any moment. Any moment this match will end. And I guarantee Killer K will be on the losing end of the pin. Big splash in the corner, puts him back into the side headlock, tagging in his partner, Saint Vengeance. Big drop kick to the side headlock. Big camel clutch, putting all his weight on it, and Killer K still not giving up. I apologize, but if you're gonna beat Killer K, you're not gonna do it by submission. The man will never, ever quit. Your only choice is to knock him out for the 3 count. Big shoulder block after he reverses the Irish whip into the corner. Grabbing the arm, whipping him into the other corner. And a clothesline to the back of the head as he hits him with the Russian leg sweep. 1, 2. Oh, and only the 2 count gets Killer K. Not quite enough to win those tag team titles. Remember, the camera adds 10 inches.
Well, that's the case.
And the ego trip suplex. And that's probably it. And the Saints of Truth still not bringing those titles home. Gotta admit, the heart of this kid, Killa K, just taking it to it. Saints of Truth gotta be getting frustrated at this point. Maybe wondering if they can actually take him down.
Come on, baby.
But things still looking bleak for Killa K. I've never seen Killa K so limp, such a ragdoll. He has just had his backside handed to him. They are beating him like a government mule and feeding him puppies. I just wanted to say both. Wringing his neck around that rope, riding the Bronco.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
And same vengeance, finally impressing people and counting to 10 without looking at his fingers. And Drix tagging himself in. You gotta assume that he's not in there to help Killa K one bit. And hitting him with that big Enzo step kick. Oh, and Truth holding him for that big roaring elbow. And it looks as though he roaring elbow. What is this? The big pile driver as Big Sexy Venom comes out, seemingly helping Killa K take out the Saints of Truth. Ducking. Oh. Ducking Drix, spearing that dude, Truth.
What was that? Johnny, what are you doing?
Kicking the ref and giving it all to Killa K. With that wheelbarrow headlock driver. What's this one? Two. And the shoulder up. The shoulder up. Big Sexy Venom not quite doing the job. And a huge bear hug flapjack.
Use his arm! 1, 2, 3.
Yeah! And ladies and gentlemen, somehow, some way, Big Sexy Venom has made sure that the now defunct DK Adventures have become the tag team champions.
It froze.
Sorry, iPod froze. Wouldn't have that problem if it was a Zoom.
And the winner, and the our new
tag team champions.
OCWS tag team champions of the world.
Not appreciating the help in becoming tag team champion obviously was not part of the plan.
And the same ones that I ride with be the same ones that I die with. Put it all out on the line with. If you're looking for me, you can find wit in the new car or the crown wit. My new bra does a fine check. In the one squad, I'm down with. Ain't no way around it.
Drix not appreciating one bit that he is now the tag team champion. At no point was that the goal, and it seems as though Big Sexy Venom may have ruined everything for the Saints of Truth. Yes, Drix, your leg hurts. You should keep running on it. And the huge shooting star press as the cow jumps over the moon.
I'm on to bigger and fucking better things now. Fuck you, Killer. Fuck the tackle.
And we're back
with OCWS Memorial Show.
damn right I'm a white boy.
Go wild.
I am just so sick. Not the Saints of Truth, but just that third scumbag that wrestles for. That's that stupid ass sellout Drix.
Yeah!
Yeah!
You know what? I'm calling out a fucking challenge right now. Wrestle Insomnia. I want him. I want to beat him up. I want to fuck him up. I want to pile drive his ass through this ring. There's nothing more I want than to do nothing but to hurt Drix. Skills would be nice.
Marijuana.
Beat him up. Break his neck.
Break his neck.
Beat him up. Drix. Beat him up. If you're a man, you come out here and try and fuck him. At least give me a word to the old fuck.
Fuck
yeah.
I've seen
him.
You want
a match for us or something?
I've got one answer for you. A little bit longer. A little bit longer.
Oh! What is going on?
Classic.
What is going on?
And the awful waffle did not work.
Not an awful waffle, dipshit.
Well, suck my dick, fat man. Yeah, yeah. You would know, because you can't even see yours.
I can see yours in your mom's mouth.
Yeah, I like incest. What about it?
Another cash.
Cause some things just don't change. It's better when they stay.